Alex Masek getting the start today. It's his third start now of the season. He's looked good so far on the year, a 1-1 record, but he's really pitched solid so far in both of his starts. He comes in with an ERA of 0.54 through 13 innings pitched. He also has good strikeout numbers, 10 so far on the season, and this is another guy that you had a chance to play with in your high school career. So a big game for Masek here with his first season with Post 59.
Yeah, Milford High School really brings a lot of good talent over to this Legion team, and Alex Masek, is another great example of this. Pitched very well for the high school team this year, despite their underachieving season. He was really a stabilizer in that rotation. He comes into Milford Legion, you rattled off the numbers just there. Very impressive so far. Mixes a good fastball, mixes it in with a good curveball and changeup. Changeup and curveball really being the two out pitches. He locates the fastball well, and like Coach DeVito said in the coach's corner, he's going to scatter some hits. They don't expect him to be perfect, but the defense is going to be behind him tonight, and we should be expecting him to throw a very good game here against Northbridge.
And so we will continue on now with our pregame show. First, we'll get to our injury report, which is brought to you by Milford Regional Medical Center, one of the nation's top 100 hospitals. And Joe Sanchioni continues to be out of the lineup, but still progressing well from that elbow issue he suffered with the collision with Matt Tessina a couple of nights ago up in Worcester. So we expect Sanchioni back in the lineup sooner rather than later. That's really the only injury to speak of for Post 59 as they enter action tonight. So that is our injury report. And first we start with the visitors, Northbridge Post 343. Leading it off is the shortstop, Justin Stone, with Devin Baroth playing left field and batting second. Tommy Sperino is the right fielder for Northbridge today. He bats third, with the cleanup hitter Mike Taroni playing first base. Mark Flores is the designated hitter, batting fifth, with Jack Marzek, the third baseman, batting sixth. Liam Cunningham plays center field and bats seventh, with Jake Hamill playing second base, batting eighth. And in the ninth spot and catching today is Isaiah Alvarado. And for Milford Post 59, the starting lineup looks like this. Matt Tessina in the leadoff spot, playing shortstop. Batting second and playing center field is Sean Ribello, with Aiden Wild in the number three spot, playing third base. Kevin Valentine is the cleanup hitter, playing first, with Brian Espin at the second baseman, batting fifth. Blake Hill is in the sixth spot. He plays right field, with Tyler Monahan catching and batting seventh. Kyle Nocera's back in the starting lineup. He is the designated hitter, batting eighth. And in the ninth spot, playing left field, is Michael Farrell. Your pitching matchup in this game, as we mentioned, Alex Masek will toe the rubber for Post 59. And on the Northbridge side, it will be Chris Brower getting the opportunity to make the start here today. And again, as we mentioned, Tommy Sperino not on the hill, as he is a dominant ace for this Northbridge staff, a very talented pitcher, as this team is very deep with starting pitching all the way around. And really, these two teams, Anthony, just really 1 through 5 in the starting rotation throughout the bullpen, two of the more premier pitching staffs in the league. So you would think coming into this one, at least the way these teams line up, that you're a couple of runs could easily make the difference in this one.
Well, it doesn't get much better than this. Beautiful night at Fino, rivalry night between Milford and Northbridge. A lot of action between these two the last few years, a lot of upsets on either side. So this should be a great matchup here tonight at Fino Field. Doesn't get much better than this.
And one other quick note to make in the Milford lineup in terms of what we saw last night. Michael Farrell back in there for the second straight game in the ninth spot. He makes the start in left field. And we were talking about this, Anthony, prior to the game, but Michael Farrell coming through with a couple of key bunts late in the game as Milford was trailing that game early, was able to get on with a pair of bunt singles. He scored a run each time he made his way onto the bases, so really provided a nice spark out of that spot.
Well, the ironic thing is I don't think either of those bunt singles were meant to be bunt singles. I think they were meant to be sacrifices. A little bit of a lapse defensively on the Wachusett side made those turn into bunt singles, but he's really a spark. He was struggling a little bit offensively this season, so to see him come through with those couple of bunt singles should jumpstart him offensively, and he'll look forward to carry that into the game tonight.
All right, we've got the national anthem coming up here, so we will step aside. We'll be back with the first pitch next here on WMRC. Show Tim Coette and Anthony Mazzini on the call tonight. Craig D'Alessandro manning the controls back in our NewEnglandFatLoss.com studios. Just a few miles down the road here on Main Street in Milford. And we are anxious to get this one underway. But before we close out our pregame show, we will get to our game time temperature for today's game. 76 degrees here at field level. And clear skies overhead, still some strong sunshine splashing across the field. Most of the field still in full sunshine, with the shadows slowly creeping in from the right field side. But absolutely ideal conditions for baseball, as this is game number 12 on the season for Post 59, 12 out of 24. So this is the halfway point in this regular season schedule. Amazing that we've already gotten this deep in the schedule just 2 weeks in. It has been a frantic pace, but Milford is set to go here tonight as Alex Masek is ready to deal in the first pitch to the leadoff batter for Northbridge, Justin Stone. Masick into his windup. Here is the pitch. And it misses outside for ball one, and baseball is underway here at Pheno. Milford post 59, taking on Northbridge post 343. Masick ready to deliver his 1-0. It is hit on the ground up the middle. Ranging for it is Espinette, but it sneaks underneath his glove and threw out into center field. A chance possibly for Espinette to make the play, but that ball snuck underneath his glove, took a tricky hop there at the end, and Stone is aboard.
Yeah, that was a tricky bounce on Espinette there. It was going to be a tough play either way. He was ranging to his right, needed to backhand that ball, but a tough hop bounced right over his glove, and Stone will reach on a single to lead off the game.
Immediately the leadoff man aboard is now Devin Baroth. The left fielder stands in on the right side, with Stone jumping out to a lead. Showing bunt is Baroth. He offers at it and may have made contact. It was fouled away right at the plate for strike one.
Looks like Northbridge is going to play a little bit of small ball to start off this game. Like you mentioned in the pregame, one or two runs really might be the difference in this game tonight.
A long look in for Masick from the sign, for the sign, I should say. And now instead a check over at first base, and Stone is back safely defensively for post 59 tonight. Tyler Monahan behind the plate, Aiden Wild at third, Matt DeCina at short, Brian Espinette at second, and Kevin Valentine at first. Left to right in the outfield, Michael Farrell, Sean Rabello, and Blake Hill. Masick now doubling up on pickoff attempts, but Stone able to get back in once again. As we mentioned, Milford dropped a tough game to Northbridge last weekend by a final score of 3-0. Again, Baroth showing bunt. This time he pulls the bat back and takes a ball, evening the count.
It's always tough to deal with the lead runner getting on base to begin the game, because as a pitcher you need to worry about him and his speed. So having Stone get on really puts Northbridge at an advantage here against Milford and Alex Masick.
One ball and one strike. The runner takes off. Here's the pitch. It misses low. Monahan can't handle it cleanly, and he will not get off a throw as Stone is able to steal second to get himself into scoring position. And so now, quickly a man in scoring position for post 343. Here's the next pitch in. This is hit on the ground up the middle. Another chance for Espinette. This time he plays it cleanly. And his only play is at first, where he's able to get Baroth for out number one. But with that ball hit to the right side, it gives Justin Stone a chance to advance to third with only one out.
And that's a productive out there by Baroth, putting that ball to the right side of the infield, allowing Stone to get to third base. And it makes that steal by Stone all the more important. That could have been a double play ball right there, but after that stolen base, he's able to advance to third.
One down now for Tommy Sparino. Talented pitcher, also very comfortable with the bat, and he takes a pitch high for ball one. Interesting to point out that Justin Stone did have a stolen base in the game against Milford back on June 18th. It came in the bottom of the fifth inning, and that steal ended up being crucial as he came around to score on an error in the outfield to break a 0-0 tie. It's one ball and one strike now on Sparino. Stone out to a lead in foul ground at third. Masick winds and deals and misses outside. A big start for Masick against the first place team in the zone. No doubt feeling a little bit of pressure as he takes the mound this evening. Ready now with the 2-1. It swung on and hit on the ground towards second base. This will get the run in as Espinette will fire to first to get Sparino, but Northbridge able to successfully manufacture a run in the inning on the single, a stolen base, and a pair of ground outs. They're able to take a 1-0 lead.
And another productive out there by a Northbridge hitter, Tommy Speroni, realizing that the corner infielders were playing back, and the middle infielders were playing back, hits that ball to the second baseman and easily allows Justin Stone to come in with the first run of the game for Northbridge.
So now two outs and the base is clear ahead of Mike Tironi. And Tironi takes the first pitch in for a called strike one. Tironi went 1-for-3 when these two teams squared off last. He had a double and ended up scoring a run as Northbridge took the 1-0 lead in the sixth, but then in the fifth, I should say, and then in the sixth inning were able to tack on two big insurance runs. Tirone starting off that two-run rally with his double. Here is the 1-1 now, and it misses down and away. And now a two-ball, one-strike count on the Northbridge cleanup hitter.
The good news so far for Mason is he's keeping the ball down, not a lot of hard contact off him so far.
Next pitch, this is hit hard on a line to third base, but snagged on the way by for Aiden Wild. A snow cone style catch made over there at third for Wild. And that out will end the inning, but Northbridge is able to get a leadoff single, and they push that run across to take a 1-0 lead over Post 59 after half an inning. It will be Milford who will take their first swings of the game when we come back next here on WMRC First Class Radio. A 1-0 lead after just half an inning for Northbridge, so immediately Milford will have to play catch-up. They'll send Decina, Ribello, and Wild to the plate. The usual suspects atop this Post 59 order against the left-handed tossing Chris Brower. And the first pitch in for Brower, a fastball for strike one.
Second night in a row, Milford is facing a left-handed pitcher, so they should be familiar with the arm angle and the way the ball comes out of a left-hander's hand.
Here's the 0-1 now, and that misses low, evening the count. Can immediately see a bit of an interesting delivery out of Brower. Now a hard hit ball on the ground up the middle. That's going to sneak through for a base hit. Right back up the chute, and it makes its way into center, and Decina is on with the base hit.
And so far, similar starts to the inning for both Milford and Northbridge. Justin Stone led off the inning for Northbridge with a single up the middle. Decina starts Milford's half of the inning the same exact way.
That will bring up Sean Ribello. A couple of hits in the game last night, upping his batting average for the season to .368. Also tied for the team lead in runs scored with 10. And 7 runs batted in on the year, and even .400 on base percentage, as the good numbers continue for Ribello in his first year. Brower instantly paying close attention to Decina at first. And Ribello takes the first pitch for strike one. Surprisingly, Matt Decina does not have a stolen base yet on the season. He's been a fixture atop Milford's lineup for the last several years and known for that good speed on the bases. So interesting to see if Coach DeVito will set him loose here, although once again, tough to get a good jump on a left-handed starter.
And a lot of times, a player can be as fast as he wants to be. A lot of times, it's a lot just getting reads off a pitcher. He maybe doesn't get the best reads.
Now coming to the plate, this one is lined out to center field off the bat of Ribello for a base hit. Decina will move up to second base and hold there. So Milford is in business here in the bottom of the first inning. Back-to-back singles. Two on with nobody out, with Aiden Wild due up next.
And Ribello continues his hot hitting. Last night, our player of the game here, after going 2-for-4 with 2 doubles and 3 RBIs, continues off to a good start here tonight with a single.
And excellent speed now at both first and second. And Aiden Wild, who leads the team now in a number of offensive categories, a .389 batting average coming into play this evening. Still waiting to see the first pitch of the at-bat as Brower spins off the mound, looking to Cena back to the bag at second. Both runners out to a good lead, as now here comes the pitch to the plate. It misses for ball one.
With anyone else at the plate, this would probably be an ideal bunting situation, but not with a hitter like Aiden Wild at the plate. And on deck, Kevin Valentine, so two very powerful hitters in this Milford lineup.
Here's the 1-0 pitch. It's hit hard to the backstop, evening the count. At a ball and a strike, Aiden Wild now with 6 extra base hits on the season, 5 doubles and a triple. He got his first triple of the season last night. And 13 RBIs, which leads the team. Here's the 1-1, and it's bounced foul over in the direction of the third base dugout. 1-2 now on Wild.
Come on, man.
And another look in for the lefty Brower. Here is the pitch, it's down low. Two balls and two strikes now with nobody out and two aboard for Post 59. Once again in their home white uniforms, Northbridge with navy uniforms with red lettering as this one bounces in the dirt. The catcher Alvarado couldn't find it initially, and so that will fill up the count to Aiden Wild.
Good job on the last couple pitches of Aiden Wild laying off a few pitches in the dirt. First pitch, a breaking ball that bounced in the dirt. This one, a fastball or a changeup. Good job of him laying off.
Here's the payoff pitch, and it misses down in the dirt for ball four. And the bases are loaded with nobody out. And now Kevin Valentine striding to the plate. And we'll see an early mound visit here. This is struggles that we don't typically see out of a Northbridge pitching staff. But right now, a pair of base hits followed by a walk, and Milford will have a bases-loaded opportunity coming up with their cleanup hitter at the plate.
Not a good way for Brower to start his outing, especially after being spotted a one-run lead in the bottom of the inning.
Again, Milford trying to end a personal five-game losing streak to Northbridge, and looking at those five losses, Milford unable to score more than three runs in a game in their last five tries against Northbridge. And they've been shut out in three of those five games. So putting a lopsided number on the scoreboard here in the first inning would be a big help. Kevin Valentine swinging at the first pitch. He hits it deep in the air out to center field. The catch is made there by Cunningham, tagging up at third base, and coming to the plate is DeSina. So credit Kevin Valentine with a sacrifice fly. And it brings in the tying run. We're now all knotted up at one.
It's a very productive out by Valentine, knowing the situation. Anything deep enough in the air will bring a runner home. He does a great job, got a pitch in his wheelhouse right down the middle, and it took it out to center field, and a good job by DeSina getting back to the bag and racing home to score Milford's first run to tie it up.
And also a good job for Sean Ribello, who was able to tag up at second and advance to third, so Milford has the go-ahead run at third base, with Wild still at first, one down now for Brian Espinette. Brower sets, here is the pitch. And Espinette swinging at that first offering, and he fouls it up over the backstop. Espinette, another of Milford's many lefty bats facing this lefty starter. Here's the pitch, it's low. Espinette, a good batting average heading into play tonight, .343. Has a total of 12 hits, a pair of doubles. He has six runs batted in. Like to tack on to that stat category here with the go-ahead run at third base. Brower checking on Aiden Wild at first base. A relatively close play, but Wild able to get back in. One ball and one strike the count. Here is the pitch, and Espinette drives this one in the air out to right field. Sparino settling underneath. He makes the catch. Tagging at third base is Ribello. The throw is going to be cut off on the center of the diamond as Ribello comes in to score. The second run of the inning for Post 59, the second sacrifice fly, and Milford is able to take a 2-1 lead.
Good recognition on that last fly ball by Valentine for Ribello to get to third. That made it very important as now Espinette with the sac fly out to the right fielder Sparino and drives in another run to give Milford a 2-1 lead.
So now the lone runner on the base is Aiden Wild. He remains at first base now with two outs. And Aiden Wild at the, or excuse me, Blake Hill at the plate. The pitch drops in low. It sneaks through the wickets of the catcher Alvarado, and that will allow Wild to move up into scoring position. So one ball, no strike count to Blake Hill. Now the pitch, this is driven in the air down the left field line. Will it stay fair? No, it twists foul completely out of Fino Field. That had home run distance, but foul. One and one the count to Blake Hill now. The windup and the pitch. And an off speed that misses just inside, a very close pitch.
That looked like a very good pitch by Brower. I think he got a little bit unlucky with the call from the home plate umpire. That looked like a good breaking ball on the inside half.
Now the 2-1, and that is up near the head of Hill. Missing badly with that one, and now the count goes to 3 balls and 1 strike, and already Northbridge with activity warming up on their sidelines. So maybe a short leash for Brower in this game. Ready to deliver his 3-1 pitch now, here it is. And this is in the air, out to right field. Sparino settling underneath once again. He is there, and he makes the catch for the out that ends the inning. But Milford able to get their first 3 men on in the inning. They score 2 times. And they're able to leapfrog ahead of Northbridge now 2-1 as we will head into the second inning next here on WMRC First Class Radio. Well, Milford, a productive bottom half of the first inning, responding to the single run for Northbridge in the top. They score 2 in the bottom. And so now it is Milford who owns a 2-1 lead as Alex Masick retakes the mound through 14 pitches in the first inning and now delivers strike 1 into Mark Flores, the designated hitter.
This is an important inning for Masick here, being spotted a two-run advantage, a two-run inning, with now a 2-1 advantage. It's a good inning for him here.
And now a swing and a foul ball in and out of the mitt of Monahan. And so Flores quickly down in the count. We saw Mark Flores out in left field for post 343 in the last matchup. Ended up reaching base on an error. Officially went 0 for 3 in the game. Takes a pitch that misses outside, wouldn't chase, and the count goes to 1 and 2.
That's a good pitch by Masick, a designed pitch outside, looking to get the hitter to chase.
Now goes right back there again, but pulls it a little bit closer to the strike zone, gets the call, and Flores is down on a called strike 3.
And that's exactly why you go just off the plate outside. That pitch, he goes right back to the same spot, except a little bit on the plate this time, on the black. That pitch that looked a little bit outside, last pitch now is on the outside corner, and that's a great sequence by Masick.
One down now for Liam Cunningham, excuse me, Jack Marzik, the third baseman. Marzik followed by Liam Cunningham. And the 1-0 pitch in is a called strike. Masick working that outside part of the plate to these righty hitters. Here is the 1-1, and this is a bouncer straight back up the middle, a long run for Espinette. He is able to track it down, but his throw is wild towards first base and bounces into the Milford dugout, and that will allow Marzik to reach and advance into scoring position.
When Espinette got that ball, he was behind the second base bag. With his strong arm and with the runner's speed, he did have a chance. But that's a very tough play. He had to leap and make the throw. He really should have just eaten that one.
So immediately, post 343 with the tying run in scoring position with one out. And so you would think that that would go as a single for Marzik and then an error getting him down to second base. So Milford's first error of the game. And now a long hesitation for Masick before he starts in against Cunningham. Here's the pitch now. It's popped up, first pitch swinging. Lofted in the air out to shallow right field. Another chance for Espinette, and he's able to make the catch. So a very quick second out of the inning. And a chance now for Masick to get out of the frame if he can get the best of Jake Hamill.
So far, Brian Espinette has been very busy at second base. He has handled most of the outs so far, and there's even been a couple singles his way so far. So Espinette is getting a lot of action early on.
Jake Hamill, a tough day at the plate against Milford pitching last weekend, went 0 for 3 with 2 strikeouts. And now takes a called strike 1 at the knees against Masick. Righty versus righty matchup. Marzik out to a lead at second base. Here is the pitch. And that hits for strike 2. No balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs in the inning. Masick looking for a K to shut down this inning with a flourish.
Masick has been very impressive with his sequencing so far.
Here is the 0-2, and it's a bouncer down the third base line, but foul. It kicks off into the third base dugout.
Another good job of hitting his spot, Masick did, getting that fastball up in the zone. A design pitch by Monahan behind the plate, looking to get the hitter to chase. Masick didn't get it up just quite enough.
Stays 0-2 as Hamill settles back in at the plate. Here is the pitch, and it bounces in the dirt, ricochets away from Monahan onto third base. Goes Marzek. He takes a wide turn there, but will hold. And so now, after the wild pitch, a runner at third base. Marzek representing the tying run, very close there at third. And a one ball, two strike count on Hamill.
That's a tough pitch for Monahan to block behind the plate. Looks like Masick just kind of yanked a curveball, held onto it a little bit too long, and with the spin, tough ball for Monahan to block.
Here is the 1-2 pitch. This is a line drive. That's out into left field for a hit. And around to score comes Marzek. And we are tied once again now at 2-2.
Yeah, ready for Northbridge number 5, Isaiah Alvarado.
That's good hitting by the bottom of the order for Northbridge. Jake Hamill coming through with a base hit. Tie the game at 2.
So an unearned run charged to Masick, as Northbridge is able to come through with a big two-out base hit. Masick ahead, no balls and two strikes, but the wild pitch, and then the single. So now a man at first ahead of Isaiah Alvarado, who lines a pitch foul into the Northbridge dugout. And Devin Baroth was able to make a catch on that foul ball on a line and fired it right back into play. Nothing and one the count, a lead at first for Hamill. A big secondary lead as the pitch misses down and away.
And if there's one thing I know about Alex Masick, he's not going to back down from a challenge. No matter how bad things get, he's going to go out there and continue pitching to the best of his ability. We'll see if he can get out of this inning here.
1-1 the count. He winds and fires, and that is a strike right at the bottom of the zone. And an interesting atmosphere here at Pheno, as a lot of the Northbridge fans have collected right behind the plate, so a lot of the reactions to this game that we are hearing are in favor of post 343. The Milford fans more down the first baseline and in the concession stand pavilion area. Meanwhile, a pickoff check at first base that was very close. It looked like they had Hamill leaning, and according to the infield umpire, just able to get the fingertips back on the bag.
Yeah, that was very close. A great move by Masick. He has a very, very good move. That one was a very close play at first base. I thought they had him.
So Masick now ready for the 1-2 delivery. And a close pitch that misses. Monahan looks back as if wondering where that ball missed. It looked like a good strike three right at the knees.
I heard Coach Steve Matos on the Milford bench wondering where that pitch was, too. A couple of controversial calls by the home plate umpires so far tonight. That zone on the outside part of the plate looks to be a little bit in question.
Two balls, two strikes, two outs. The runner takes off. The pitch from Masick is hit on the ground up the middle, fielded once again by Espinette. The throw to first base is a bit low, but handled cleanly by Kevin Valentine, and that will do it in the top of the second inning, but Northbridge is able to push across the tying run. We are once again knotted up now 2-2 as we will head to the bottom of the second inning next here on your home for Milford Legion Baseball, WMRC First Class Radio. Right back inside Pheno Field for the bottom half of inning number 2. Milford taking on Northbridge. It is tied at 2. Northbridge with 2 runs on 3 hits. Milford 2 runs on 2 hits. And Milford also with a miscue in this one. They will bring up batters 7, 8, and 9 against the lefty Chris Brower back out on the hill for his second inning of work. So Tyler Monahan settling in. Monahan really has that batting average up at a good spot now at 364. Takes a look at the first pitch up and away against Brower. Monahan with an infield single and a run scored yesterday against Wachusett. Now sends a pitch far out of play, foul, evening the count at a ball and a strike.
Moynihan is a good example of someone who's taking advantage of an opportunity. Wasn't catching consistently at the beginning of the season, but he's caught two consecutive nights, and he's taking advantage, like you said, that batting average creeping up now.
2-1 the count. Moynihan with 8 hits overall on the season. He also has a double and a home run as part of that hit total. 3 runs batted in. And now in the driver's seat in this at-bat, up 3 balls and a strike. And now on the 3-1, this is bounced straight back up the middle. It gets past the glove of the second baseman, Hamill. And for the second straight inning, Post 59 will have their leadoff man aboard.
And we see the approach that both of these teams are taking, driving the ball to the middle of the field and away. No balls have been pulled so far. We see it again here with Moynihan driving a ball up the middle on the ground for a base hit.
So Tyler Moynihan aboard at first. And now Kyle Nocera back into the lineup once again, today serving as the DH. And now a pickoff check over at first, and Moynihan just back. It was a good move that time from the lefty Brower, and Moynihan, who didn't have a big lead, was caught a bit flat-footed.
And I wish I could have helped him. I saw that play was going over to first base as soon as he picked up his foot, but I couldn't say back on the radio, so fortunately, luckily for him, he was able to get back.
A no ball, one strike count now on Kyle Nocera, and limited at bats so far on the season. 7 at bats coming into the game today. A batting average of .286. Does have 2 runs batted in. And now takes a strike right at the bottom of the zone.
Milford is still waiting for Nocera to get back on the mound for them. A valuable piece of their pitching rotation. So any contribution he can make at the plate will be beneficial, but they can't wait for him to get back on the mound.
Takes a pitch down in the dirt, blocked out in front by Alvarado, and that will keep Moynihan at first base. Tyler, not the fleetest of foot in this Milford starting lineup. 1 ball, 2 strikes now. Tirone holding Moynihan on at first, who has just about a 2-foot lead off the bag. Nocera takes the pitch low, and now the count evens at 2.
Yeah, Alvarado does not need to worry about Moynihan trying to steal, unless it's in a hit-and-run situation, but doesn't look like he's going to be taking off on his own.
The set by Brower. Here's the pitch, and it's swung on and missed. The ball not handled cleanly by the catcher, but with first base occupied, Nocera can't make the attempt to reach. He goes down via the strikeout. It is the first K in the outing for Chris Brower.
And that was a good pitch. Started off with the letters and broke back down towards the knees. Nocera seemed to be well out in front of that, looking for a fastball maybe, and he swung right through it.
So with one down, here is Michael Farrell. As we mentioned in the pregame, walked away with 2 bunt singles in the game yesterday, and each time he reached base, he scored. Very productive out of this number 9 spot.
And for someone who had been struggling, a lot of times just getting on base will really put you in a groove.
Here's the 1-0 pitch. It's up and away. And a nice play by Alvarado to leap and make the grab and prevent that ball from going to the backstop.
Yeah, with the exception of one pass ball, he's had a lot to deal with back there. A few balls in the dirt. He's handled most of them very cleanly so far.
Here now is the 2-0. Again, he misses up and away and in danger of walking the number 9 hitter. One out in the inning with Moynihan remaining at first base. Here's the 3-0 pitch. It misses low for ball 4, a 4-pitch walk to Farrell. And now Milford will have men at first and second with DeCina up for his second at bat.
Yeah, it looks like Brower was overthrowing his fastball a little bit. He was missing up and away, realized his fastball wasn't catching any of the plate, so he tried to go with the curveball on the 3-0 count, and that one misses too. So they'll turn the lineup over now to DeCina, who singled in his first at bat.
So now pitcher and catcher with a conference going on, and as the catcher Alvarado heads back behind the plate now, Coach Demasian out from the Northbridge dugout, so the meeting will continue. And it looks like we will see a pitching change is now popping out of the dugout behind Coach Demasian. Is the reliever, it will be Isaiah Wadsworth, who we did see warming up on the sidelines last inning, so it will be a quick hook tonight for the Northbridge coaching staff as they will put in the reliever, so we will step aside for the pitching change. Milford will have runners at first and second, one out, and Matt DeCina at the plate when we come back next in this tied ball game on WMRC First Class Radio. The new pitcher on for Northbridge post 343 is Isaiah Wadsworth, as Northbridge will keep the left-handed pitchers going on the mound as Brower exits the game after just an inning and a third. Three hits allowed, two runs, two walks, a strikeout. He's responsible for Monahan at second base and Farrell at first. As now the lefty Wadsworth deals with Matt DeCina, who swings at the first pitch looking to dump it out into center field, but a good jump from Liam Cunningham out in center field, and he's able to make the catch.
Yeah, initially off the bat I thought that one was going to fall in, but a good jump by Cunningham turned on the jets there at the end, and good closing speed to be able to track that one down and keep the runners where they are.
So two outs now in the inning. Runners hold at first and second. It'll take something from Ribello to try to put some runs on the scoreboard. He swings and misses at the fastball from Wadsworth. The lefty working very quickly, has the sign. Now checks the runners, comes to the plate, and that pitch misses a little bit inside, evening the count at 1-1.
And Ribello in his last few at-bats, three hits in his last five at-bats, dating back to last night. He's excelled in these situations with runners on base.
Here's the 1-1. It misses away. Both runners on, the responsibility of the starter, Brower, as Wadsworth again comes set. Here's the pitch, and it's swung on and missed. Looked like maybe Ribello got just a piece of that one, foul tipping it into the mitt of Alvarado. So now two balls and two strikes. Now the windup and the pitch, and this is a line drive out towards the gap in left center field. That's going to be down for a hit. It rolls deep into the gap out in right center. Around to score comes Monahan. They will hold Farrell at third base as Monahan crosses the plate on the two-out RBI double from Sean Ribello. He comes through once again in the clutch and puts Milford back on top 3-2.
And the hot hitting continues for Ribello. We saw it last night. Two doubles with three RBIs. He adds to the total tonight. Another double with runners in scoring position. Drives in another RBI. And the hot hitting continues for Sean Ribello, a Bellingham graduate.
And now quickly, Aiden Wild, first pitch swinging, lines one towards the backstop, over the backstop, and that one nearly snuck in the press box window. A full press box here tonight, not only with our WMRC setup, but our good friends from Milford TV here as well, and also Northbridge cable access in the house, so plenty of media coverage tonight, and you certainly can understand with a matchup of this magnitude. Aiden Wild now about to see a 1-1 pitch, and that just grabs a piece of the outside part of the plate, says the home plate umpire, and the count goes to 1-2.
And you mentioned the media coverage for tonight's game with the emphasis. That's probably part of the reason why Brower got the early hook tonight. Game with such emphasis is very important.
Now Aiden Wild also taking aim at that left center field gap. The ball down for a hit. Two runs will score as both Farrell and Ribello cross the plate. On the RBI double from Aiden Wild, Milford back-to-back big two-out run-producing hits, and they open up a 5-2 lead on Northbridge.
And this 2-3-4 combination for Milford, Ribello, Wild, and Valentine is certainly paying dividends these last couple of games. Ribello with the RBI double in the bat one batter ago, and now Wild coming up with two runners in scoring position with a double and two RBIs to extend Milford's lead.
Even though it has only been 8 days since these two teams have played, you get the feeling that the comfort level that Milford feels at the plate now versus where they were at back on June 18th, they're a very different team now, much more comfortable, much more poised, and it's really showing through here in this inning, coming through with two huge two-out run-producing hits to take the lead back. This one is dribbled down the third base line, started foul, now kicks back fair. Valentine a little slow out of the box, and he will be thrown out by the third baseman, Jack Marzek, to finally bring an end to this bottom of the second inning. But back-to-back two-out RBI doubles from Sean Ribello and Aiden Wild, and Milford is able to take a 5-2 lead on Northbridge as we will head to the third inning next here on WMRC First Class Radio. Milford now with 5 runs on 5 hits with 1 error. Northbridge 2 runs on 3 hits with no errors. But key 2 out at bats taking place in that bottom half of the second inning, as Sean Ribello and Aiden Wild power this Milford offense once again. A double and an RBI for Ribello, two RBIs on the double for Aiden Wild, and a 5-2 lead for Post 59 as Alex Masick gets set to deal with the top of the Northbridge batting order. Justin Stone about to dig in for the second time tonight. And Masick ready to deliver the first pitch, and that's in for strike one.
And Masick must appreciate this offensive output by his other teammates here. Now he's going to look to set down the Northbridge lineup, 1-2-3, but he's going to have to go through a difficult part of the lineup with the top of the hitter, Stone.
Now a one ball, one strike count as that pitch missed down and in from Masick. Allowed a two-out RBI hit to Jake Hamill last inning that at the time tied the game. But Milford fighting right back. Now 2-1 the count. Masick up to 35 pitches in his outing. Here's the 2-1. And that narrowly misses. And now Stone up three balls and one strike. That last pitch may be a little bit high. Now Masick delivers the 3-1, and that is a strike. And looked to be a good deal further off the plate than the last one, and maybe a makeup call for the home plate umpire, and that fills up the count.
Well, I got to tell you, Tim, this home plate umpire has looked a little bit uncomfortable back there. A lot of the calls he's been making have been very late as well.
Here's the 3-2. This is a fly ball out to shallow left center field. Sean Ribello once again with a terrific read, and he is able to make the catch for out number one.
Good jump on that ball by Sean Ribello. Made a good closing speed on that ball, came in, cut off Michael Farrell a little bit in the outfield, but the center fielder takes charge on any ball that he can get to, and he'll record the first out off Justin Stone.
Stone, a good base runner, good to keep him off the base paths here with now one out, and a swing and a miss from Devin Baroth. Masick now picking up the pace with the bases empty. Here's the 0-1. It's in for strike two.
Good curveball there. Started that off on the front hip of the hitter, Baroth. Curve right back into the strike zone.
Here's the 0-2 now, and that is on the outside corner for a called strike three. A three-pitch strikeout of Baroth to bring the second out here in the top of the third.
And it really doesn't get much better than that. Right on the outside corner. Looked to be a little bit of a pitcher's pitch. Might have been a little bit away, but that's close enough for the home plate umpire to ring up Baroth.
Two fast outs for Masick, now looking for that shutdown inning. First dealing with Tommy Sparino. He swings at the first pitch, hits it on the ground to the left side, past the glove of Wild. And DeCina there to back it up, but he couldn't play it cleanly, and Tommy Sparino will reach.
I think that one was going to be a single either way. That's a tough play in the hole. Once Aiden Wild can't get to that ball on the dive, it's going to be a tough play for DeCina. And with Sparino's speed, I think he's going to make it either way. That should go as an infield single, in my opinion.
Definitely a good effort from both infielders on the left side. Aiden Wild diving in towards the center of the diamond. Glanced just off his fingertips, was backed up by DeCina, but by the time he got to it, could not make the play. But meanwhile, first pitch swinging, Tironi pops it up in foul ground behind first base, and he's able to make the catch. So Masick ends up having to throw just one more pitch in the inning to conclude things in the top of the third. Northbridge does not score, so Milford maintains the 5-2 lead as we'll head to the bottom of the third inning next on your home for Milford Legion Baseball, WMRC First Class Radio. Brian Espinette, Blake Hill, and Tyler Monahan, the three batters expected, as Espinette takes a called strike one to open up the bottom of the third against Isaiah Wadsworth, who came on to pitch the final two-thirds of the second inning. And Espinette now down in the count, nothing and two. Wadsworth allowed two inherited runners to score, was also charged with a run of his own on two hits. Here's his 0-2, and that's inside on Espinette.
Another close pitch, probably should have been called a strike by the home plate umpire. That one might have just dropped into the zone a little bit too high. Good job of framing it by Alvarado, but I personally think that one should have been called a strike.
Instead now the 1-2 count, and the pitcher steps off the back of the pitching rubber, so Espinette backs out, now digs right back in on the left side, ready to see the 1-2. A little bit up and away, and the count now evens at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
And a very quick pace by the pitcher Wadsworth here tonight. Coming in out of the bullpen, really gets the ball and immediately looks in to get the sign and throws it.
Here's his 2-2. This is fought off back up the middle. That's going to drop into shallow left center field for a base hit. Not very hard hit for Espinette, but well placed. He floated it up over the infield and dropped in front of both Baroth and Cunningham in the outfield. So Espinette leading off this inning with a single, and right now Milford has had the leadoff man on in every inning, and in every inning so far that leadoff man has scored.
Yeah, he actually got jammed on that pitch. That was up and in, but he kept his hands in enough and was able to get a decent part of the barrel and just shoot it out into the left center field gap.
Now Blake Hill swings at the first pitch and lofts it up over the backstop. Hill 0 for 1, a fly out to right field his first time. Nothing in one the count as Espinette leads off of first. He holds as the pitch is grounded back to the first baseman. He will throw to second to get the out there. The relay to first is in time. And Northbridge able to turn the 3-6-3 double play. It was hit hard right into the glove of Tironi at first base. And he was able to get a quick throw off to second base to get the out there. And despite Hill hustling down the line, the throw back to first was able to beat him just by a running step.
That's a good job by Tironi. That's got to be a split-second decision of whether he tags the base and throws to second or throws to second first, but he made the right call. He was just far enough away from first base that wasn't really an option. Good throw to the shortstop, and then the relay throw over back to Tironi was able to turn the double play.
So now an opportunity for Northbridge to bring a quick end to this inning as it started off promising once again for post 59, but the double play clears the bases now with two outs. And it's a 1-ball, 1-strike count into Monahan. Now working on a modest 3-game hitting streak after he came through with a single back in the second. Came around to score. 2 balls and 1 strike. Here is the pitch. And it's fouled away. Stands behind home plate about as jam-packed as we've seen them so far this season. The only bad news for Post 59 is the majority of those fans are cheering for their opposition. Here's the 2-2. It's hit on the ground towards shortstop. A tricky hop in the end for Stone, but he handles it. And he's able to fire to first base in time to get the out that retires the side. So in the end, Wadsworth just faces 3 men in the inning and is able to set down Post 59 with no damage done. We've now played 3 full innings from Pheno Field. And it is Milford 5 and Northbridge 2 on your home for Milford Legion Baseball, WMRC First Class Radio. Tim Coet and Anthony Mazzini up here in the Pheno Field press box bringing you all the action tonight. And a good performance through the early innings for Post 59. The offense able to tack 5 runs on the scoreboard against Northbridge pitching so far, and Alex Masick, 43 pitches deep into his outing, will get this 4th inning started facing Mark Flores, Jack Marzek, and Liam Cunningham. So far, Masick has scattered 4 hits. He's allowed just 1 run. It was unearned back in the 1st inning. 2 runs, one of them earned. An unearned run in the 1st inning, an earned run in the 2nd, but now allows a ground ball base hit through the right side. And quickly, Flores is on to open up the 4th.
And again, we see another ball hit the other way. Good approach by Flores, taking that pitch that was on the outside part of the plate and driving it on the ground in between that hole between first base and second base to lead off the inning with a single. Hopefully, Northbridge will look to get back into this game.
So Flores aboard. Now here's Marzek, who singled and scored a run his last time up. He gets backed off the plate on an inside pitch from Masick. This bottom part of the order was able to spark a rally for Northbridge the last time around with Marzek out of the 6th spot, getting on with a single. He was eventually driven in by the number 8 man, Jake Hamill. Now a 1-ball, 1-strike count. Just nicking that outside corner was Masick. It times. It's been a wide strike zone to the outside part of the plate to these righty hitters, so certainly a good idea for Masick to keep working to that side.
At times it's been wide, but at times it's also been very tight. We've seen a couple of controversial pitches that haven't gone the pitcher's way for both sides, for both Northbridge and Post 59 Milford.
Here's the 2-1 pitch now, that one well outside. And also low, a backhanded stab from Monahan. And it's now a 3-ball, 1-strike count to Marzek, so Masick in danger of allowing the first two men to reach in the top of the fourth. Here is the 3-1, and that had the batter Marzek jackknifing out of the way, but it hits the inside part of the plate.
And the large Northbridge population here doesn't like it, but that's a good pitch by Masick. Just because the batter is crowding home plate doesn't mean it's not a strike, whether he has to jump out of the way or not. And I think it was a little bit of an exaggeration by Marzek.
Here's the 3-2 with the runner off. The pitch is wide for ball four. It gets away from Monahan, but no further advance for the runners. Flores was off. He made it to second base easily, took a wide turn there, but did not chance making his way to third. So Northbridge is in business here with the single and now the walk. And they will bring the tying run to the plate with nobody out in the inning. And Coach DeVito now out to talk things over with Masick.
This is probably just to calm him down, remind him that he's working with a lead and he needs to throw strikes.
Milford will start getting activity going in the bullpen right now as Tyler Renault and Jake LeBlanc sprint out to the bullpen area for Post 59.
And if called upon, it should be noted that Tyler Renault has been very effective in his relief appearances.
The conference breaking up now as Coach DeVito heads back to the dugout. And Masick now getting ready to face Liam Cunningham, the number 7 hitter. Cunningham popped out to second base his first time. Kevin Valentine and Aiden Wild in tight on the grass at first and third. At double play depth up the middle as Masick starts off with a first pitch strike.
It almost looks as if Milford is expecting a bunt. They're not going to get one off that after Cunningham takes that first pitch unless they put on the bunt sign now.
They still stay tight at the corners. Here's the pitch, and that's in for strike two. Right now, we haven't seen Cunningham get the bat off the shoulder, so no indication of a bunt play on. And now Valentine will drop back deep behind the runner at first. Wild still plays in tight at the grass at third, as now this one will be hit in his direction, a room service hop. He taps the bag at third base, now goes across the diamond. The throw not in time, it was in the dirt, and a great job by Kevin Valentine of keeping that one from careening away into foul ground. So Milford is able to get the lead runner at third base. So one down in the inning, runners at first and second base.
That's a good job by Valentine of keeping that ball in front of him. That easily could have gone as an error by Aiden Wild. He did a good job of knocking it down and getting it out at third base himself, but he was saved by Valentine on the other end. Tricky hop, he was able to keep it in front of him.
Now here's Jake Hamill. And Hamill takes a first pitch strike down at the bottom of the zone. And a real heads up play on the front end on that ground ball from Aiden Wild, having the presence of mind to go to third base to get that lead runner. So it's now Jack Marzek as the lead runner at second base with Cunningham at first, who reached on the fielder's choice. A 1-ball, 1-strike count now to Jake Hamill. Here's the pitch, and that's in for strike two.
Going back to that double play by Aiden, the rule of thumb is if the ball is hit at you or towards the third base bag, you go to third first and then fire across the diamond. If the ball takes you towards the second base bag, that's the only situation that you would go to second base first. So a good play by Aiden.
Now the 1-2 pitch, and that hits Jake Hamill right on the uniform number. It looked like that was a breaking ball that just didn't break for Masick, and it ends up as a bad break for Post 59 as Northbridge has them loaded up with one out.
I got to tell you, Tim, it's very unusual to hear more Northbridge fans than Milford fans. I don't know if that was a mock cheer towards Masick, or I don't know what that was, but a lot of Northbridge fans either happy or upset that pitch hit their their number 8 hitter, Hamill.
It has been the Northbridge fans who have really made their voices heard here over the Post 59 crowd. And a big opportunity here for Northbridge with their number 9 hitter at the plate. He takes the pitch high for a ball. And right now, it is Marzek at third, Cunningham at second, Hamill at first. Bases full of Northbridge runners with only one down.
And they're very upset that Masick is pitching them in. None of these pitches, except for that one-hit batter, have been close to hitting anyone.
This is a fly ball out to right field, twisting towards foul territory, and it lands foul. That had danger written all over it, but fortunately for Milford, it kept hooking and hooked into foul ground deep down the right field line.
That was a good pitch by Masick, low and away to Alvarado. Not much he could do with that, just flicked it off the end of the bat. And when it hits off the end of the bat, the ball just kept spinning away from Blake Hill, and it eventually hooked out of play.
It's a one ball, one strike count. Runners leading at each base, and now timeout is granted by the home plate umpire. Alvarado backing out, takes a practice cut before digging back in on the right side. Alvarado 0 for 1 in the game. He grounded out his last time up. Here's the pitch. This is hit on the ground towards third base. Stabbed by Aiden Wild. He throws to second base for the out there. Here's the throw to first, and it's there in time. Around the horn they go, 5-4-3. Milford turns the inning-ending double play, squandering the bases-loaded opportunity for Northbridge. And Milford is pumped as they head back to the first base dugout. A huge defensive play in this game and a leading contender for our Stardust Jewelers Diamond Play of the Game. And Milford able to hold on to the 5-2 lead as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning next here on WMRC First Class Radio. Still a 5-2 lead for Post 59 on the heels of what might just be the biggest defensive play of the season so far for Milford. Northbridge with a bases-loaded one-out opportunity, and Aiden Wild able to start the 5-4-3 inning-ending double play, and really spectacular work all the way around the diamond as Aiden Wild had to go far to his left to stab that ball low, then sent the throw to first base, a very quick pivot for Brian Espinette. Able to get rid of that ball in a hurry, and that made all the difference, being able to get the runner at first base. And Anthony, just an absolutely crucial play made by the Milford infield.
Oh, absolutely. With that double play, it really takes a lot of the pressure off here in that inning, getting out of that inning. That was a very dangerous situation that Milford was put in there, but Masick was able to work his way out of it with a lot of help on his defense, by his defense.
So now Post 59 set to begin their half of the fourth inning. Kyle Nocera leading it off, already now with a count of one ball and one strike. And a swing and a miss here from Nocera, and he is quickly down in the count.
Just going back to that double play quickly, that was a situation where I touched on it earlier. The first play that was hit at him, he went to third base first. That double play, it was hit toward his left. He had to go towards second base, so he went to the 5-4-3 route.
Now a pitch down in the dirt, swung on and missed from Nocera, hustling down the line, but Alvarado able to recover, and he fires to first base to get the out there. Nocera, an ugly swing at a pitch well down in the dirt. He strikes out for the second time tonight.
Yeah, Nocera hasn't looked comfortable. Both pitches he's been struck out on have both been breaking balls. He seems to be way out in front. He needs to keep his hands back and his weight back and really look to drive the ball middle away.
That brings up Michael Farrell. Farrell takes a look at a pitch high. Michael Farrell able to work a walk his last time up. That walk chased the starting pitcher, Chris Brower, from the game. And now he's ahead in the count 2-0 against Isaiah Wadsworth, who has now pitched a full two innings after getting the first out here. He came on with one out in the second inning, managed to pitch a scoreless third inning, helped out by a 3-6-3 double play. And now Farrell lines one back up the middle. That's going to touch down for a one-out single.
And after getting two bunt singles last night, Farrell so far with a walk and now a single tonight. Like I said earlier, sometimes just getting on base, seeing that ball down is able to really ignite a player offensively. So far tonight, on base twice, and he might be finding his groove at the plate.
And a very speedy runner now at first base for Post 59 as Matt DeCina will take his third at bat. Immediately, Wadsworth checks on Farrell at first, who was able to get back standing up. DeCina singled in his first at bat and came around to score the first Milford run of the day and flew out to center field his last time up. Takes a pitch inside here for ball one, and that was close to nicking the right elbow of DeCina, who didn't look like he was all that inclined to get out of the way.
I think it's kind of funny how the Northbridge fans don't react when their pitcher pitches inside, but they get all up in arms when a Milford pitcher pitches inside on them.
Farrell off with the pitch as DeCina grounds it foul, and that evens the count at a ball and a strike. A man on with one down for Milford. And now a long look in for Wadsworth, the lefty, now sets. Here's the 1-1 pitch. And DeCina pops it up foul over the backstop and out of play. Coming into action tonight, Matt DeCina with a .263 batting average. 10 hits on the season, but he does have 10 runs scored, or he did have 10 runs scored, now 11, after he crossed the plate back in the first inning. Another check over at first base, that time a quick flat-footed move from Wadsworth.
And DeCina's batting average isn't a good indication of how valuable he is to this team. He always seems to find a way to get on base, and he's crossing the plate at a good cap so far this year.
Off-balance swing on the 1-2. He's able to foul it away off to the left. Stays alive to see another pitch. The scalding hot bat of Sean Rabello waiting in the on-deck circle. And Wadsworth now steps off, wants to go through the signs again. Chatter coming out of the Milford dugout as Farrell takes off, and the pitch fouled away from DeCina. Looks like Milford's had the hit-and-run play on at a couple of different points in this at-bat for DeCina, but both times he's fouled the pitch away.
Well, he's put in a tough situation now. He has to be very defensive. He can't really look to drive a ball with the hit and run being down in the count.
DeCina right back in on the left side. He's ready. Wadsworth ready. And instead we'll see another pickoff play at first. And each time so far, Farrell's been able to get back, staying on his feet.
Well, the scouting report is out on Milford. They like to be aggressive on the base paths. And so far, Wadsworth is very active with the runner at first base, Farrell.
Farrell holding this time as the pitch is up and in on DeCina. And that will even the count at 2 balls and 2 strikes. The lights on here at Pheno Field as we are at dusk, just after the hour of 8 p.m. Here's the 2-2. It's inside again. Now a snap throw from Alvarado down to first, and Farrell's able to dive back into the bag.
Well, this game seems to be going at a little bit of a slower pace in comparison to last night's game. So far through 4 1/3 innings here. And this game is much already past 8 o'clock. At this point last night, we'd probably be in the 6th inning or so.
Again, Wadsworth very preoccupied with Farrell at first. He sent a number of pickoff throws over in that direction. We'll see if Coach DeVito puts that runner in motion with the 3-2 pitch upcoming. He goes, the pitch, and that misses for ball four. And Isaiah Alvarado, very demonstrative behind the plate, voicing his disagreement with the umpire, now gesturing in the umpire's direction. And the Northbridge catcher needing to keep his composure here, or he could easily be out of this game.
Yeah, I can see why he's a little bit discontented. That pitch was clearly up, but there have been a few controversial calls so far, but they've been both ways. So good job by Alvarado to keep his composure there.
Now first pitch swinging, Rabello sending one in the air down the right field line, hooking into foul territory and beyond the grasp of Sperino. That will land foul. You can just see in moments like that just how high the emotions run in a rivalry game like this. Both of these teams desperately wanting to walk away with a victory. Northbridge coming into this game hoping for the regular season series sweep. Milford hoping to even things and send a message to the rest of the zone, delivering just the second loss of the season to the first place team.
When a catcher starts to argue with the home plate umpire like that, it doesn't help any situation. He's just going to stop getting any close pitches. So good job by Alvarado to finally quit arguing and keep his composure.
He lets this ball get away from him, then can't get a clean grasp on the baseball as it rolled towards the third base side, and both runners are able to advance. The runners were off immediately as that ball bounced in the dirt, but it did travel towards the third base side, so if Alvarado had handled that cleanly, he may have had a shot at throwing out Farrell at third, but then ended up not being able to pick it up cleanly off the grass, so now two in scoring position for Post 59.
And not only does arguing take your not help your situation with the umpire, but it takes your concentration away from the game a little bit, and I like to be a situation there. I wasn't able to block that ball cleanly and allowed the runners to advance into scoring position. Decina at second and Farrell at third.
Milford would love to build on this lead. Northbridge now with the infield in tight all the way around. A 2-2 pitch on the way to Ribello, and it's swung on and missed for strike three. Ribello chasing a pitch that may have been a little bit up and out of the strike zone, and he is retired for the first time tonight. Two strikeouts in the inning for Wadsworth. He now has two outs. But if he wants to get out of this inning unscathed, he's going to have to find a way to retire Aiden Wild. Wild takes the first pitch low for ball one.
And that's another pitch that could have been called a strike. Alvarado didn't do the best job of framing that, but I think that ball broke right at the knees.
One ball and no strikes on Wild, who has been on twice tonight. And now takes another close one that misses for ball two. It is Michael Farrell, who singled earlier in this inning. He's the lead runner at third with Matt Decina at second base. He worked a walk. And they will now intentionally walk Wild as he was able to jump ahead in the count 2-0. They don't want to take the chance with Milford's hottest hitter. Not every day you see the intentional walk at the Legion level, but you can understand it as now ball four nearly snuck its way back in towards the strike zone. But Wild not offering at it, and he will head down to first base. They're loaded up for Kevin Valentine.
I understand this situation, but at the same time I don't, because you go from one extremely dangerous hitter to another. It is a lefty-on-lefty matchup, but Valentine is just as dangerous right now as Wild is.
And now Valentine takes the pitch that just sneaks in at the bottom of the strike zone for a called strike one. Valentine, a sacrifice fly in the first and grounded out to end the second, takes a pitch down and away that almost snuck past Alvarado. Stuck that glove out towards the right side batter's box to haul it in. Now a 1-1 pitch and a wave and a miss from Valentine, fooled. And he is down one ball and two strikes. Three men on for Post 59 with two outs. Wadsworth kicks and deals, and this one is hit softly back towards the mound. The fielding play by Wadsworth, he fires to first, and that out will retire the side. So we've seen a bases loaded squander now on both sides. Milford, a great opportunity to pad their lead, but they can't get it done. And we have completed now four full innings from Pheno Field. It is Milford 5 and Northbridge 2. On coverage of Milford Legion Baseball here on First Class Radio and streaming online at WMRCDailyNews.com. Before we get started with the top of the fifth inning, let's quickly run through the final scores around Zone 4 from last night's action. Framingham with an 8-5 win on the road against North County. It was Sturbridge notching a road victory 4-1 over Cherry Valley. Shrewsbury a 10-0 Mercy Rule win over Cherry Valley, as Cherry Valley was in doubleheader action yesterday. Leominster a 12-0 win over Northboro. Maine South 5-2 winners over Eastside, and Milford of course a 7-2 win over Wachusett. And Northbridge able to just edge out Grafton Hill by a final score of 2-1 that gave Northbridge their 10th victory of the season. The only loss for Northbridge so far on the year came to the team right below them in the standings, Shrewsbury. That was a 7-4 win for Shrewsbury earlier on in the season. So Milford looking to do what only one other team has done so far in 2016, knock out the top team in the standings.
And also, as we rattle off score recaps today, it should be noted the Red Sox dropped their second in a row, so there will be no game updates in tonight's coverage.
Tough loss once again as the Red Sox end up dropping 2 out of 3 in Texas. Back to live game action here at Pheno. Alex Masick working against the top of the Northbridge order in the fifth. And he has Justin Stone in a count of 1 ball and 2 strikes. Stone singled and scored a run in the first, then flew out to center field his last time up. Winds and fires, and the pitch misses down and away. So yesterday we had doubleheader baseball coverage with Legion leading into the Red Sox. Today it was the Red Sox first, and now Post 59 closing out the night. Here Stone gets into this pitch, drives it out to left center, but again, Sean Ribello with great speed able to make the catch, and every ball that's hit out in the direction of center field, it just seems like Sean Ribello finds a way to get there to make the play.
That's the second time Ribello has retired Justin Stone tonight. First in the third inning and now here in the fifth. He just gets a great jump on the ball and great closing speed allows him to track down anything that's within his reach.
Such a great track record for defensive play in center field for Post 59 teams. As now first pitch swinging, Devin Baroth sends one foul down the third baseline. Of course, the previous few seasons we've had a chance to watch Kevin Lynch operate out in center field, and prior to that it was Ian Strom, who of course now is a proud member of the New York Mets organization, drafted earlier this spring. It's a no ball, one strike count on Baroth. Here's the pitch, and that's a little bit too low.
Well, that's something I didn't know about Ian Strom. That's very good news for Milford Legion alumni, so congratulations, Mr. Strom.
Product of Hopedale High School, was a standout player there, a standout player here for Post 59, and a very solid baseball resume. Also, some very productive seasons for UMass Lowell, and also a couple of seasons played for the Worcester Bravehearts in the Can-Am League, as now this pitch is popped foul up over the backstop, over the press box, and off into the woods behind us to bring the count to 1-2.
And it just goes to show a situation with Mr. Strom that just because you go to a smaller school doesn't mean you can't get recognized. And while it might not be one of the bigger time Division I schools, specifically down south, if you're a good player, you're going to get recognized. So congratulations, and his hard work has gone a long way.
We look forward to continuing to monitor the progress of Ian in the minor leagues. Alex Masick with a count of 2 balls and 2 strikes to Baroth. Here is the pitch, and that misses badly for ball three. Far outside. Milford did have activity warming in their bullpen last inning as Tyler Renault got loose. So you have to think that Coach DeVito is very closely monitoring Alex Masick here in this fifth inning. Here's the 3-2 pitch. It's hit hard on the ground through the left side of the infield for a one-out base hit. One for three now for Devin Baroth. He's at first base now ahead of Tommy Sparino, who drove in a run on a ground out in the first inning and then reached on an infield single in the third. And so we're seeing a similar style outing for Masick here tonight that we saw earlier this week against Wachusett. A lot of base runners. We haven't seen a 1-2-3 inning out of Masick so far tonight. But he's been able to minimize the damage more often than not. Here Sparino sends one hard on the ground. It takes a tricky hop off the heel of the glove of Aiden Wild at third and travels out into left, now two on with one out. And Northbridge threatening again.
And that's a tough one to score because although it was hard hit, it did take a tricky bounce. Aiden Wild could have done a little bit of a better job getting his body in front of that one. So that one could go as an E5 or a single.
We'll score it an E5 here for our purposes. We'll confer, of course, as we always do, with the official scoring from Tim Walsh down in the dugout after the fact. And now Masick able to send in strike one to Mike Tirone, the cleanup hitter for post 343, who has been held quiet so far. He did send a hot shot to third base his first time up that was caught by Aiden Wild and then popped out in foul territory behind first base his last time up. Sends a ball foul to the backstop here, so he's quickly down in the count, nothing and two. Masick would love a strikeout here. He has two so far on the night. Pitching with Baroth at second, Sparino at first. Here it is, and it's flared foul over the backstop.
You'd also appreciate a ground ball right here. Milford has proven they can turn two. Saw it last inning. The first one didn't work out, but Aiden Wild was able to start one to end the inning last time, so a ground ball wouldn't be a bad thing here either.
Still an 0-2 count to the right-handed hitting Mike Tirone. Here's the pitch, and it's hit back up the middle, fielded at shortstop by Decina. He throws to second out there. Here's the throw to first, not in time. A very close play at first. The ball and the runner getting there at right about the same time. It looked from the naked eye as if Milford was able to turn it, but not so, says the infield umpire, positioned right behind the pitcher's mound, making the ruling.
That one was very close. It could have gone either way. Must be a situation where the tie goes to the runner, but I agree with you, Tim. That looked like the ball did beat Tirone running down the line, so Northbridge catches a break here.
They have a man at third base. Also, Tirone safe at first on the fielder's choice, so runners at the corners now. And a big at-bat coming up for Mark Flores. Batting now 1-for-2. He has a single. That came back in the fourth inning and then struck out looking back in the second. It was Sparino who was retired as the middleman in that attempted double play.
I think it's interesting to note that this is the first time that a Northbridge hitter has batted in consecutive innings.
Flores leading off that fourth inning. Of course, post 343 with the bases loaded and one out last inning. It took a terrific play from the Milford infield to turn an inning-ending double play. A swing and a miss now from Flores, so he's down 1-2, two outs in the inning. And the Northbridge base runners will take their leads now off of first and third. A deep breath from Masick as he comes to the set position. Now fires a pickoff throw over to first base, and diving back in was Mike Tirone.
This is a situation, first and third, where you often see the runner at first take off, see what the infield alignments are. It doesn't look that way with Tirone, though.
Flores digging back in on the right side, now levels the bat over the shoulder. Milford leading 5-2, but Northbridge with the tying run at the plate. The runner takes off from first. Here's the pitch. It's grounded towards the left side. A slow roller for Decina. Waits for it. Now fires to first base and gets the throw there in time for the out. That retires the side. A good play from Decina. Good strong throw over to Valentine at first. And Northbridge will strand two men on base. And that concludes things in the top half of the fifth inning. Still 5-2 Milford as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning next here on coverage of Milford Legion Baseball on First Class Radio. So we'll see some changes here for post 343 as we enter into the bottom of the fifth. Moving in from center field to take over on the mound is Liam Cunningham. We'll try to spot a uniform number out in center field. Looks like it may be Brian Iarussi out in center field. We'll try to get confirmation on that as the inning goes along. But Cunningham now the third Northbridge pitcher as he fires ball one into Brian Espinette. Isaiah Wadsworth coming on in relief, pitching 2 2/3 innings. He allowed one run on four hits, and here Brian Espinette sends a floater over to shortstop. Stone able to make the catch on the line, and Brian Espinette quickly retired. Now 1-for-2 officially in the game.
Wadsworth really did a good job for this Northbridge team coming in
after the wheels kind of fell off on Brower's outing, he did a good job of stabilizing in 2 2/3 with only four, scattering four hits and only allowing one run after Brower had allowed four runs.
Blake Hill up at the plate now. Hill 0 for 2 so far. He bounced into a 3-6-3 double play back in the third inning. That was after Milford had gotten their lead runner on. And now Hill making hard contact on the ground, but right to Jake Hamill, had a little trouble as the ball bounced out of his glove, but right at his feet, and was able to make the short throw to first base. Hill retired 4-3. And Milford with two quick and quiet outs to start off their bottom half of the fifth inning.
Yeah, it was hard contact by Blake Hill, but unfortunately it was right at the second baseman, Hamill, and it was an easy play for Hamill to throw over to Tironi and able to get Blake Hill.
1-0 the count now to Tyler Monahan, who is 1-for-2. Now swings at this pitch and hits it high and foul off to the right. One and one on Monahan, who now steps out. A long look in now by Cunningham. The righty deals. Tyler sending this one in the air out to right field. Sparino in his tracks at first, now drifting towards the foul line. He is able to make the catch. And for the second time so far in this game, we see an inning in which only three batters come to the plate, as Cunningham does good work out of the bullpen, setting down Milford 1-2-3. We head to the top of the sixth inning when we come back next, as Alex Masick trots out from the dugout. He will return to the mound for his sixth inning of work next on WMRC First Class Radio. A defensive substitution for Post 59, as we're about to see the beginning of the top of the sixth inning. Jeff Bisazzi now takes over behind the plate. Tyler Monahan out of the game. We got just a quick notification from Coach DeVito from down at field level, and it looked as if Coach DeVito gestured to his knee as he mentioned the defensive change, so possibly Monahan coming out of the game with a bit of a knee issue. So Jeff Bisazzi, who started this game on the bench, now comes in behind the plate.
Yeah, unless it's an injury situation, I don't quite understand the move. One hit have been playing well so far, 1-for-3, very sound defensively, so it must be an injury, but that's why Coach DeVito is down in the dugout and I'm up here. I'm not the one making the calls.
First pitch swinging now. Jack Marzek sends it right back up the middle. That is through for a base hit. That is now the seventh hit for Post 343 on the day. And Anthony, we had this conversation in between innings. Would Coach DeVito send Masick back out for this sixth inning? He's now 82 pitches deep in his outing. We've seen a lot of high leverage work out of Masick through these middle innings. And would you have been better served leaving this as a fresh inning for a reliever? Instead, he sends Masick out there and now continuing to go with his starter here with the lead runner on.
And my argument was, I think he was going to bring them back in. He has a 5-2 lead to work with. He's facing the bottom of the order now, starting with the number six man. So they have Renaud ready if they need him. I think they wanted to bring him back out there, see if they could get him a couple more innings, and if he runs into trouble.
And now a double play ball hit up the middle, but a little bit of a bobble from DeCina. He was able to get the out at second base, but no chance to get the man at first. If DeCina had been able to play it cleanly, they may very well have gotten the runner at first base, but it knocked out of DeCina's glove. He was able to keep his cool to get that lead runner at second base, but no double play. One down as Cunningham is able to reach.
I think they'll go with Masick as long as they can until he gets into serious trouble. We saw him get that first out of the inning there, and they have Renaud ready if they need him.
So Cunningham at first, now Hamill at the plate. Jake Hamill swings at the first pitch and pops it straight up on the infield. It's DeCina who wanders in just behind the pitcher's mound. He makes the catch. So after an ominous beginning with the leadoff single from Marzek, now it is two outs with Cunningham, the runner at first base. And now back down to the number nine hitter, Isaiah Alvarado, who came to the plate in one of the most crucial moments of this game. One out and the bases loaded in the top of the fourth inning, and ended up hitting into an inning-ending 5-4-3 double play. And we've also seen the emotions pour out of Alvarado behind the plate earlier in this game on a pitch that didn't go Northbridge's way, so it's been a bit of a tough day for the Northbridge catcher. Here's the 1-0 pitch, and that drops low and away.
Good block by Bazzazzi just coming into the game cold. Good backhanded stop, was able to keep that ball in front of him and didn't allow Iarussi, I think that is, at first base. Nope, all right, I'm sorry about that.
Liam Cunningham, the runner at first base. Iarussi coming into the game defensively, who...
And Cunningham still kept his spot in the lineup. That's where I was a little confused. Sorry about that.
Northbridge no longer with the designated hitter, with the pitcher, with Cunningham now operating as the pitcher. That should leave Iarussi now in the number five spot, which was previously occupied by Mark Flores. Meanwhile, a quick walk here for Masick against the number nine hitter, not what he was looking for, and now here is Coach DeVito out of the dugout. This may very well be the day for Masick.
And I think this is the trouble that I was referring to. Now, even with two outs, a first and second opportunity, getting to the top of the order again now with Stone, who did single off him in the first inning, so they're going to go to the fresh arm. Good day for Masick, but he's going to turn it over to the bullpen now. Tyler Renault coming into the game.
Getting congratulations from his teammates. A round of applause from the Milford fans here in the house. A good day for Masick, who is able to go the first 5 2/3, but he will give way here to the post 59 bullpen. It will be Tyler Renault, who will be on the mound next in a 2-on-2-out situation. A quick break, and we'll be back with more here in the top of the sixth next on First Class Radio. The left-handed reliever Tyler Renault now completing his warm-up tosses under the watchful eye of head coach Steve DeVito. We've seen a lot of work, a lot of good work out of Tyler Renault in this Milford bullpen. This is now his fifth appearance of the season. He comes in with a record of 1-1, a 4.42 ERA. In 6 1/3 innings pitched, he's allowed a total of 9 hits, 5 runs, 4 of them earned. He's hit a batter, walked 2, and struck out 6. Really just one rough outing so far out of the bullpen that has those numbers a little bit elevated. That was 2 nights ago at Tivnan Field. He allowed 2 runs in an inning of work against Grafton Hill. A rare off night for this post 59 bullpen. Runners at first and second as Renault sends the pitch in as a called strike 1 to Justin Stone. The lefty reliever facing the right-handed hitting Stone, who is 1-for-3 tonight. Here's the pitch. And that had a lot of life on it from Renault. It missed inside.
I wonder what opposing teams think when they see Renault trot onto the mound. He's not a very tall kid or a very big kid. He's only kind of short and scrawny, but he really gets that fastball up there. It's very deceiving.
And now a called strike 2 at the knees. One and two now the count as this ball is hit on the ground to DeCina. He will go the short route to second base to get the force play that will end things here in the top half of the sixth inning. So again, Northbridge threatens, but once again, they cannot capitalize. The score remains Milford 5 and Northbridge 2. Northbridge has had men on base in every inning so far tonight. They have stranded runners in each inning from the second through the sixth. They've stranded a total of 6 runners on base throughout the game. And as a result, Milford has been able to hang on to a 5-2 lead as we have now moved on to the bottom of the sixth inning. And Milford will try to push across some insurance runs here in this frame. They will send up Kyle Nocera, Michael Farrell, and Matt DeCina facing the right-handed tossing Liam Cunningham out for his second inning of work from the bullpen. A 1-0 pitch on the way to Nocera. He slices it to the opposite field, down the right field line, a fair ball. Now traveling into foul territory, Nocera taking the turn around first base, but he holds there with a solid leadoff single.
And I'm sure Nocera is happy with that. Struggled early on in the game, strikeout in the second and a strikeout in the fourth, both swinging, and he's able to get a good piece of this one and line it over the first baseman Taroni's head for a leadoff single here in the bottom of the sixth inning.
You could see Nocera, the emotion coming out after he came through with that hit, slapping the hands together as he rounded first base. He will now give way to a pinch runner as Derek Izzo comes into the game. Getting a little bit of extra speed at first.
And we know against Northbridge, no lead is a big enough lead, so good sign for Milford to maybe get some insurance runs here in the bottom of this sixth with a lead runner on after the single by Nocera.
And Cunningham sensing that Milford might have that runner in motion, sending an early pickoff throw in that direction, but Izzo back safely. Michael Farrell now at the plate showing bunt. He misses, takes the pitch low for a ball, but meanwhile a big secondary lead for Izzo, and he gets thrown out by the catcher on the snap throw. He had a huge secondary lead and just kind of hung out there about a third of the way down the line, and it was an easy call for Alvarado, who fired over to first base. So just like that, the bases are now empty with one out, a crucial mistake for Izzo.
And that's an assumption play by the pinch runner Izzo. Despite Farrell's prowess as a bunter, he didn't get that one down. Izzo assumed he was going to, basically was on his way to second base, but he gets thrown out.
And now on the next pitch, Farrell sends one on the ground to second base, handled easily by Hamill. A 4-3 ground out, and a much different complexion to this inning now. The base is empty, two outs. And now we'll see the fourth trip to the plate for Matt Tessina. He's officially 1-for-2. He singled in the first and then drew a walk his last time. As we mentioned, a lot of media attention on this game tonight with our good friends from Milford TV in the house, which means that everyone out there in the listening audience will have a chance to see all of the sights as well as the sounds of this game coming up on Milford TV's educational channel. In just a couple of days from now, we'll also have the game up on YouTube. Quickly, an 0-2 count to Tessina. Here he carves the pitch foul and out of play off to the left. No balls and two strikes on Tessina. Cunningham ready for the next pitch. It drops in too low. And now a 1-2 count, looking ahead to the top half of the seventh inning. Northbridge will have some of their bigger hitters coming up to the plate, so important for Milford to try to grab some insurance runs in this inning, but again, they have the bases empty with two outs.
A promising inning took a turn for the worse, and with the meat of the lineup coming up for Northbridge, that would have been an important insurance run.
A generous strike three call right at the bottom of the zone. Tessina down on strike three. It's the first strikeout for Cunningham since coming into the game, so he does his job. He gets out of this bottom of the sixth inning unscathed, so it will be a 5-2 lead for Post 59 into the top half of the seventh inning, three outs away from what would be their biggest victory of the season. Tyler Renault heading back out onto the mound, looking to close it off for Milford. Can he do it? We'll find out next here on WMRC First Class Radio. Seventh inning time here at Pheno Field in Milford. Post 59 taking on their arch rivals, Northbridge Post 343. It has been an entertaining ball game here tonight. A lot of fans here to enjoy it, a lot of Milford fans, a lot of Northbridge fans, and coming down to the wire now, Milford up by three, and Tyler Renault looking to end things here, three big outs to get. As now first pitch swinging, Devin Baroth sends one out to center field, but on the move, it's Sean Ribello who makes the catch. And a first big out recorded in the top of the seventh.
Yeah, we've seen it all night by Ribello, getting a good jump on that ball. That's a tough ball to read off the end of the bat. Came right at him, but he made a good jump on it, good read, and was able to record the first out of the inning for Renault.
Now the first pitch into Tommy Sparino, and that misses for ball one. Everyone on the edge of their seat here at Pheno. Renault ready with his next pitch. It's dribbled on the ground to shortstop. Ranging play for Tessina in towards the infield. He fires across in time. to get the out. Two very quick outs for Renault in the inning. Northbridge down to their last out as Mike Tirone now comes up.
Well, Tim, I got to tell you, I wish they played nine innings. This one's been exciting.
It's been a well-played game all the way around. A lot of big moments, a lot of big plays on both sides. But right now, Milford one out away from a big victory. But the cleanup hitter for Northbridge at the plate looking to keep things alive. A big swing, but he comes up empty for strike one against Renault.
And again, there's that deception by Renault. Not a big kid. Doesn't look like he's going to be overpowering. It's probably easy for opposing hitters to underestimate him. But he blew that one by.
And now this pitch is floated in the air out to center field, ranging towards the right center field gap is Ribello, but he loses track, and the ball drops onto second base. Now goes Tirone. He's safe there, and the game will continue. Oh, that looked like a routine fly ball that would end the game. And for all of our accolades on Sean Ribello tonight, he just inexplicably lost that ball. He looked like he had it sized up, but then took his eye off of it. Maybe felt Blake Hill coming in from the right field side, but that drops to the turf and a break for Northbridge as the inning keeps going.
I think that's a situation where that ball just got lost in the lights. He saw it off the bat. Once it got up so high, he probably just lost it. I've seen that happen many times throughout my high school career. A lot of summer leagues I've played in, the lights can be kind of tough here. Once you hit it up in those lights, you don't find it. He was in the right direction. It actually landed like 2 feet away from him. So the prowess we've been talking about as for Ribello as a center fielder, he botches that one, but you know, hopefully it won't come back to bite him.
No error on the play as Ribello was not anywhere near the ball, so a gift double for Tirone. And so now Renault trying to bear down here and bring an end to the inning, as we will still see Mark Flores at the plate operating out of the DH spot, and he now falls behind. No balls and two strikes. We did see Cunningham come in from center field to pitch, but Northbridge maintaining their DH spot. Flores 1-for-3, but he's down, nothing in two. Here is the pitch, and it's swung on and missed for strike three. So despite things getting a little interesting here in the seventh inning with that ball dropping in center field, Renault comes back with a three-pitch strikeout of Mark Flores, and that is your ball game. Milford exercising some demons here at Pheno Field tonight. They break a five-game losing streak to Northbridge dating back to last season. They deal post 343, just their second loss on the season, as Milford wins by a final score of 5-2. So the home crowd will leave happy. The Northbridge fans quietly now heading for the exits, but a terrific victory for Post 59 here tonight, as now they head down the handshake line with Northbridge. A well-played game on both sides, but Milford able to come out on the winning end again by a final score of 5-2. What a game here tonight.